Oh, after ng ating discussion about air quantities, better that we now go to the methods of handling supplied air in conditioned spaces. Now, isa lang naman yung may tuturo ko sa inyo dito, yung pinaka-basic at fundamental ng ating air conditioning. So, how will we handle in different methods? So, I have here one method. That is all outside air supplied to the room without recirculation. So, as is lang, kung paano mo siya ipinasok, hindi mo na i-recirculate yung air na yun. Okay? I-disregard mo na yung recirculation. So, the use of all the outside air without recirculation is uneconomical. Unless, ba't ko sinabing uneconomical? Kasi, supply ka lang ng supply ng air. Hindi mo nire-reuse yung air na yun. Diba? Yung air na yun, kung sinupply mo siya sa isang room na malamig at itatapon mo lang, di magpo-produce ka na naman ulit ng supply air na ganong quantity ang meron. Now, it is very uneconomical. Bakit? Gumagamit ka ng power and yung cooling effect niya is tinatapon mo lang na itinatapon. So, all throughout the process, you have been taking out too much heat dun sa ating outside air. Hindi mo ginagamit yung air na sinupply mo at bahagya lang iinit. Now, it is uneconomical unless the outside conditions are close in temperature and humidity to the inside condition nung i-maintain mo dun sa condition space. This method is usually applied to hospitals where, tama nga naman, hindi mo pwedeng i-recirculate yung air. Lalo na, meron tayong mga viruses like COVID, di ba? Kaya itatapon mo yung hangin na yun outside. So, supply ka ng supply ng air, you will never reuse that air by using recirculation process. Kasi nga, ang hinahanap natin din, hindi lang air quality. It is the safeness of the air that is present and supplied. So, I have here one problem that will be best for us to understand the system. So, let me introduce you to the problem. The problem goes like this. 75 cubic meters per second of air, outside air, at 38 degrees dry bulb. So, ibig sabihin, ambient air nasa labas mo. And it is measured at 22 degrees wet bulb. It's cooled and reduced to its temperature to 11 degrees Celsius after ng conditioner mo. The system utilized all outside air supplied to the room method. That provides, yan natin to highlight natin. Yan. That provides 17 degrees Celsius supply air temperature inside the conditioned space. The air is maintained at 22 degrees Celsius at dry bulb and 50% relative humidity. So, yung 22 and 50 degree, 50% relative humidity, pasok yan sa ating tawag dito, comfort cooling zone. Yan. So, let me draw the entire process. Let me first draw it. Okay. So, our method is the most simple method na meron tayo. You have here yung inyong ducting system. Well, dun sa ducting system mo, bago pumasok ang iyong, sorry sa drawing ko ha, yun yung ducting system natin, papasok yung iyong outside air with the mass. It will go through filters. Yan. Hindi naman pwedeng yung supply mo is as is, so supply ka lang na ganyan. Dadaan yan sa yan, filters. Pinifilter din ng hangin for solid objects na masasuck in niya. So, you have here the conditioner. Ayan, yung air conditioner natin. Hindi ko talaga ma-perfect yung drawing. This is the conditioner with the cooling coils. Saan galing yung cooling coils na yan? That is coming from your simple refrigeration system or simple vapor compression system. And this is your condenser. This is your compressor. So, gumagamit yung compressor mo ng compressor work. Ito, nagtatapon ng heat reject. QR sa refrigeration. Tapos, nandito yung cooling and humidifying process. Mamaya, papakita ko sa inyo. And then, dito, papastro na dyan. After your conditioner, you'll have several conduits. Okay? Kung saan that will pass through a process kung saan tatanggalin mo yung humidity. Anong tawag doon? Reheating? Yan, reheater. Then after your reheater, it will pass through a yan, fan system. That it will supply dun sa ating condition space. Yung ating condition room. Yan. Pagpasensya nyo na yung aking diagram at drawing. Okay. So, pakita natin yung process. Okay? Yung outside air mo, it will go through a series of filter para to take out the solid objects before it will be absorbed in a process kung saan magkakaroon tayo ng cooling and humidifying. Dehumidifying. Ayan. And then, ito na yung air mo. Okay? Kung saan yung air mo, magtatapon po yan ng condensate. And then, magtatapon yan ng init. Okay? Dito sa ating, i-absorb ng ating cooling coil. Now, this is your point one. This is your supply mo na dito is mas na ng air yan eh. This will become point 2. And dito, sa process na to, reheating, okay? Where SH2 is equal to SH3. Okay? Diyan sa reheater na to, itong process na to. So this is now your point 3 before going into fan. Where your fan, we assume na walang heat absorb or heat given off sa fan na yan. Only thing, ang lalagyan mo lang ng velocity, yung air mo. Okay? So, this is still 3. Ngayon, meron ka ditong mass ng supply air. And yung supply air na yon papasok sa inyong condition space at point 4. Where dun sa condition space mo, you will maintain a certain range of temperature at dry bulb 4. That will range from 22 to 24 degrees Celsius for comfort cooling conditions. Yan. And then, yung RH dapat niyan between 40 to 60 degrees Celsius. Kaya nga naging 15 nandun eh. Now, magkakaroon ka na dito ng QS and QL. Yung mga loads, heat loads. Where that will total to QT. Okay? Ang process naman dito, kung ang process dito is cooling and dehumidifying, dito nagdadagdag ka ng heating and humidifying. Kasi meron ka ng heat loading dyan. Now, we say that at point 2, it is saturated. Oh, Bakit saturated? Kasi yung RH mo dito is totally 100%. And what happens with your temperatures kapag 100% yan? It is equal to yung dry bulb mo sa 2, equal yan sa dry bulb, wet bulb 3, wet bulb 2, equal yan sa temperature dew point at 2. And yung temperature dew point at 2 is the apparatus dew point. Yan, nakuha nyo na kung paano. That is the apparatus dew point. Ito. Okay? So, ano pa ang mga hinahanap dito? Commonly, hinahanap natin is the flow rate of the fan. Dito sa point na to. For the flow rate of the fan, that is simply equal to yung mass ni air. Kahit saan dyan, supply kay 3. Mass ni air at point 3 multiplied to specific volume at 3. Oh, yan. Mapakuha mo yung sa fan. Let us take note. Ano po ba yung MO? That is the mass of outside air. Itong M na to, MR. That is the mass of conditioned air na. How about yung mass ng supply? That is mass of supplied air. Ganun lang po kadali isolve to. Pag dinagdagan natin ng cooling tower, ibang usapan na yan. Pero madali pa rin, same process. Pero iisa-isahin mo lang siya kung paano mo gagawin. Hindi sabay-sabay. Okay? There are times that ang pinasosolve dito yung nandulo, yung nasa mass of outside. Meron times na pinasosolve yun nandito sa part 4. Pabalik-balik lang. Okay? Pakita natin yun. Dito sa ating problem. Okay. We have this problem. Letter A, ang pinahanap sa kanya, the capacity of the conditioner in kilowatts or in tons. B, the mass of water vapor expected due to cooling process in kilogram vapor per second. Number 3, the apparatus dew point in degrees Celsius. Number 4, the heat supplied by the reheater in kilowatts. So, meron pa pala dito sa heat. Nakalimutan tayo sa reheater mo. Hindi natin nilagay yung Q ni reheater. Yan, yung Q. Yan, dyan. Okay naman yung drawing ko, naintindihan? Pwede na yan. Letter D, heat supplied by the reheater. E, QL and QS, latent heat and sensible heat inside the condition space in kilowatts. F, the moisture pickup. Yun nandun yan sa, ano, SH. And then, you draw the schematic diagram. I-drawing ko na. The fan capacity in cubic meter per second. Let us draw it. Okay. So, unahin natin yung drawing para maganda. Solution. Drawing natin siya. So, you have here. Kaya natin. Draw. Ito, para maganda. Maguin natin yung kulay. Yun. Okay, paksiw. So, you have there, sinuplayan niya dyan. Tapos, nandito yung cooling coil. Coming from your simple refrigeration system. And then, dito, yung point 2, pupunta sa reheater. Reheater, para siyang heat exchanger. And then, yung sa fan. And then sa room. Copy ko na lang to. Lakihan ko lang konti. Ayan. So, dito na siya. Ayan. This is the perfect kahit pa paano. So, lagyan natin ang mga points. This is point 1. This is point 2. This is point 3. 3 pa rin naman to. Wala naman kasi nagbago dito. And this is point 4. Now, tignan natin. Lagyan natin ang mga legends. So, point 1, nagbigay ka ng volume flow rate of air. That is 75 cubic meter in every second. Ang binigay pa dyan na dry bulb 1 is 38 degrees Celsius. Wet bulb 2 at wet bulb 1 equal to 22 degrees Celsius. Ang sinabi dito, sa conditioner space mo, may condition ka ba dyan? After nun, ito ha, pakinggan nyo. Cubic meter second. And reduced its temperature to 11 degrees Celsius. So, after passing here, okay, nung air mo, naging dry bulb siya at 11 degrees Celsius. Where, hindi naman sinabi, okay, kung saturated siya, but we assume it is saturated. Oh. Ngayon, sa reheater mo naman, we assume that SH2 is equal to SH3. And then, sa fan mo, basahin mo ha, system utilize all outside air supplied to the room that provides 17 degrees supply air. Supply air. Saan ba nanggagaling yung supply air mo? Coming yung your fan. So, the supply air is 17 degrees Celsius. Isusupply mo dito. Okay? Hindi mo alam si QS. Hindi mo alam si QL. Pero, i-maintain mo daw yung room mo. At, dry bulb temperature na 22 degrees Celsius and then RH niya is equal to 50%. And then, after nun, tatapo mo na si air. Hindi na siya magre-recirculate. So, ganito ang gawin natin. Okay? We know that RH2 is 100%. Therefore, temperature wet bulb at 2 is equal to temperature dry bulb at 2 is equal to temperature dew point at 2 is equal to 11 degrees Celsius. Now, this will be your apparatus dew point. Nasolve na natin siya. Now, for, may hindi pa sa inyo nasabi, di ba? For this method, all outside air supplied to the room method, we can say that the mass of the outside air is equal to the mass of the air at the condition space, and that is also equal to the mass of the supplied air. Ayan yun. For this method only. For this method. Kasi, hindi ka na nag-recirculate, hindi ka nag-bypass. As is, yung outside air will be the air that will be conditioned and the air that will be supplied and the air that will be taken out also of the system. Same-same na lang yon. So, we can say, we have to find all the values na nandito sa ating points. At point 1, hanapin saan? Pwedeng steam tables or psycho chart, psycho app. Pero mas mabilis yung psycho app kasi nakikita niyo yung value real time. So hanapin natin dito yung RH1 omega 1, H1, specific volume at 1, tsaka dew point at 1. Yan. RH1, go to your app. Okay. The app is here. Dry bulb tsaka wet bulb binigay. That is 38, 38, and wet bulb, 22. Oh, submit natin. Mm-hmm. Dew point. The dew point is 14.069 degrees Celsius. Specific volume. Litan ko ng konti para kita. Okay? Ayun. Specific volume is 0.896 meter cube per kilogram. Enthalpy 64.06 kilojoule per kilogram. W 0.1. Parang may mali dito sa app na to. Wet bulb, 22 and 38. Tama naman. Dry bulb and wet bulb. Check ulit natin. Refresh ko lang, ha. Wet bulb. Submit. 38 and 22. Tama naman. Ayan. Zero point. 0.01055. Kilogram vapor per kilogram air. So, ganda i-check to ng steam table. So, RH, relative humidity is 24.213%. At 0.4 muna tayo sa dulo. Mahanap na natin. Ang condition sa 4 is dry bulb. 4 is equal to 22 degrees Celsius. RH 4 is 50%. Hanapin natin si temperature wet bulb 4. Temperature dew point 4. Omega 4. Ano pa? Omega 4. H 4. And then, specific volume at 4. Going back. So, that is 22 and 50 RH. 22, 50. Submit. Humidity ratio. Wet bulb muna tayo. 15.414. 15.414 degrees Celsius. Dew point 11.112 degrees Celsius. Omega, that is 0.008258 kilogram vapor per kilogram air. H4 is 43.109. Correct. 43.109 kilojoule per kilogram. Yung V4, 0.847. Yun, tama. 0.847 meter cube per kilogram. 0.4. How about at 0.2? RH is equal to 100% kasi nga saturated. Tapos ang dry bulb at 2 is 11 degrees Celsius. Going back to the app. 11 and 100. 11, 100. Submit. Hindi natin kukunin yung iba ha. So, humidity ratio. Omega 2. H2. V2. Meron lang tatlo. Huwag mo na kunin yung dew point. Pero pwede rin naman, kunin natin yung dew point para makita natin kung tama ba yung apparatus dew point. So, the apparatus dew point para maisakto natin. Apparatus dew point 11.001. Yun pa rin naman. Degree Celsius. Yung V2, 0.816. Meter cube per kilogram. H2. Yung H2 is 31.727. 31.727 kilojoule per kilogram. How about omega 2? 0.008197. Tama. 0.008197. Kilogram vapor per kilogram air. Ano pa yung wala? At 0.3, kailangan i-up mo to. Kailangan pa ba i-up yan? At 0.3, up na rin natin to. At 0.3. SH3 is equal to SH2. SH2 is 0.008197 kilogram vapor per kilogram air. Tapos ano pang given diyan? Dry bulb 3 is equal to 17 degrees Celsius. Mahanap na natin si temperature wet bulb 3. Temperature dew point 3, RH3, H3, tsaka V3. Paulit-ulit lang yan. O, up ulit. This is 17. Tapos ito, specific humidity, multiply mo lang ng 1,000. So, 8.16. Nasaan dito? 8.197. Submit. The answer is 13.46 degrees Celsius. Dew point 11.002. RH 67.742 percent. H3 37.852 kilojoule per kilogram. V3 0.833 meter cube per kilogram. Yan. So, nakuha na natin lahat ng points. Now, let us go with this part. Sa conditioner. This part muna tayo. Mahaba talaga solving nito. Please bear with me. So at conditioner, hanapin natin yung capacity. We isolate the air, okay, and apply the mass and energy balance. By material balance muna. Mass in is equal to mass out. We have air this is 0.1 this is 0.2 so meron ka ditong mass ni dry air 1 as mass ni water vapor 1 mass ni dry air 2 mass ni water vapor 2 then what will happen yung air mo magi-give off yan ng condensate. Tama. Yung analysis natin kay dry air. For dry air. Yung mass ni dry air 1 equal yan kay mass ni dry air 2. Equal kay mass ni air. Yan yung condensable materials. Ang non-condensable, paano? Sa water vapor, mass ni water vapor 1, tignan yung mga pumasok ah, dalawa yung lumabas. Equal yan kay mass ni condensate plus mass ni water vapor 2. Okay, mahanap natin sa mass ni condensate. Diba lagi naman tayo may formula dito? Diba? Yung mass ni water vapor makukuha natin by what? Diba? Mass ni water vapor equal to mass ni air times SH. Tandaan yun. Oh. The mass ni air multiplied to SH1 minus SH. Kasi pabaliktad eh. Dalawa yung lumabas, isa yung pumasok. Next. At point 1, mahanap natin si yun yun, given kasi si volume flow rate. Volume flow rate at 1 is 75 cubic meter in every second. Tapos meron na tayong V1. So we can say we can have yung mass ni air. Oh, volume flow rate kay 1 divide by specific volume at 1. So 75 cubic meter in every second divided by yung kay 1. Hanapin natin. Ayun. 0.896 meter cube per kilogram. Ang lalabas diyang kilogram per second. So, let us solve. 75 divided by 0.896. The answer will be 83.7054 kilogram in every second. Kilogram air every second. We now have yung mass ni air. Now, we can solve for mass ni condensate. Oh, 83.7054 kilogram air per second. Multiply mo kay SH1 or omega 1 minus omega 2. Omega 1. Hanapin natin. Omega 1 is 0.1055. 0.01055 Minus. Yung kay 2. Nasaan yung kay 2? Ayan. 008197. 0.008197 kilogram vapor per kilogram air. Makancel yung kilogram air. So, mass decondensate kilogram vapor per second. So, that is 83.70 54 multiplied to 0.010055 minus 0.008197. The answer is 0.1555 kilogram vapor in every second. That is the mass of the condensate. Oh, next one. Just follow my lead, ah. By energy balance. By energy balance, where E in is equal to E out. Meron ka na namang air quantity dito. And then, yung kay 1 and 2. Siyempre, di ba meron tayo dito sa condition space ang pinag-uusapan natin, ha? Meron tayong cooling coil. Ito yung cooling coil natin. Galing sa ating refrigeration system. Yung air mo, mag-give off yan ng heat. Okay? That is QA. Okay. So, meron ang mass ni air 1. Initial, air 1, mass ni air 2, tapos yung enthalpy ni 1 at enthalpy ni 2. Okay, by energy in, energy out, we equate them. Dalawang lumabas, isang pumasok. So, mass of air 1, H1, equal to QA plus mass ni air H2. Okay, hanapin natin si QA. Is equal to mass of air multiplied to H1 minus H2. That is true. Okay? Mass ni air, 83.7054 kilogram in every second. Tapos H1, dapat mas mataas yan kaysa H2. H1 is 64.06. 64.06 minus H2. 31.727. Kilojoule per kilogram. Cancel to. So, kilojoule per second, that is kilowatts. 83.7054. Multiplied to 64.06 minus 31.727. Ilang kilowatts yan? Oh, that is 2706.4467 kilowatts. And how will we denote yung QA? QA is the heat absorbed by the refrigerant. O yan yung cooling capacity ng iyong refrigeration system. O, i-convert pa natin to in tons. O, QA in tons, 2706.4467 kilowatt in tons. Okay? Multiply mo. Multiply. 1 tor equal to 3.5167 kilowatts. Oh, hindi na naman nila tandaan yung conversion factor. Yari tayo dyan. 3.5167. The answer is 769.569.5987 tons. That is the cooling capacity of your refrigeration system or your conditioner. Okay. So, nasolve na natin yung mass ng condensate. If this is letter A, yung B, ano yung B? Mass ng condensate. That is, sinolve ko na yun ah. 0.155 kilogram vapor per second. This is B. How about letter C? Tignan natin. Ano yung pinasolve sa letter C? Apparatus dew point. Ito na, letter C. TDT2. 11 degrees Celsius. That is letter C. Letter D. Heat supplied by the reheater. Oh. Letter D. Q reheater. Q reheater. Paano yun? Problema dyan sa reheater. Dito ko na lang tumingin. Okay? Tignan mo na lang to, yung diagram. Okay. Yung reheater mo, ito. Yung reheater mo, nag-give off yan ng heat. Okay? Nag-add ka ng heat. Oh. Tapos, meron ka ditong, ewan sa diagram mo. Ayan o. Ito naman, reheater ka naman. Dito ka naman. 2 to 3. Reheater. Oh, 2 to 3. Process 2 to 3. M3. Ah, hindi. M2, M3. Tapos H2, H3. Now, alam mo na agad, yung QRH is equal to, mas mataas yun nandito, okay? MR H3 minus H. Ano yung M ng air? 83.7504. Kilogram in every second multiplied to H3. What is H3? H3 is... Sana sa H3. Hindi ko mahanap. Ayun, 37.852. 37.852 minus H2. Nandito sa H2. Eh. Nadaan na natin kanina. Ayun, 31.727. Kilojoule in every second. Kilojoule every second. Kilojoule per kilogram. Cancel yung kilogram. Oh, we can solve for RH. 83.7054 multiplied to 37.852 minus 31.727. The answer is 512.6956 kilowatts. Solve na siya. How about letter E? QL and QS inside the condition space. Letter E. QL and QS. So, wag muna natin i-solve to. Set aside muna natin. Kasi pwede na natin ma-solve si fan. Q, fan. Yung Q ng fan, that is M3. Pwede rin M4, tapos V3. M3 is simply, ito na yun, no? 83.57054. Multiplied to V3. V3, V3, V3. Nasa dulo. Ayun, 0.833. 0.833 kilogram per second multiplied to meter cube per kilogram. So, ang lalabas is meter cube per second. Kilogram, kilogram. 83.7054 multiplied to 0.833. The answer is 69.726 meter cube in every second. Nasolve na natin si Cunifan. Anong part to? Letter. Ayun, H. That is the fan capacity. Isolate natin. At condition space. At condition space na tayo. Ibilugan natin. Kapag kayo nagdo-drawing na schematic, mas maganda, bago kayo mag-solve, at pagkatapos mag-solve, bibilugan nyo, ina-isolate nyo. So, this part na. Okay? Sa condition space na tayo, gagamit ulit tayo ng material balance tsaka energy balance. Yan. Sa condition space. By material balance, lagay mo uli yung hangin mo. Air pa rin naman yan. Meron kang 0.3, meron kang 0.4. Yung mass ni dry air at 3, mass ni dry air at 4, mass ni water vapor at 3, mass ni water vapor at 4. Ngayon, meron tayong init na i-absorb dyan kasi galing dun sa load na yan eh. Mass ni steam. Now, yung analysis natin sa dry air, paulit-ulit yan. Mass ni dry air 3 is equal to mass ni dry air 4 equal to mass ni air. Yung kay water vapor naman, yung mass ni water vapor 3, tatlo yung pumasok. Ayan. Adalo yung pumasok, steam. Tapos palabas si isa. Plus mass ni steam equal to mass ni water vapor 4. Inulit lang naman natin yan eh. Okay? Inulit lang naman natin yung proseso. We can say na yung mass ni steam, dinerive ko na yung kanina, equal to mass ni air multiplied to SH, yung mas mataas, 4 minus SH3. Okay? Ito na yun. So, mahanap na natin si mass ni steam. Ito yung mass of steam added in the condition space. Yan na yun. So, we can solve. Multiplied natin ng 83.7054 kilogram in every second SH4. SH4. 008258. Minus SH3. Nasa dulo yan. Yun, 0.008197. Kilogram vapor per kilogram air. Cancel to, cancel to. So, kilogram vapor per second yan. 83.7054 multiplied to 0.008258 minus 0.008197. The answer is yung ganun. Okay na. So that is equal to mass of the steam 0.005106 kilogram vapor in every second. That is the mass of steam. Now, the moisture pickup, dun lang naman mangyayari. Ito yung moisture pickup mo ngayon. Nangyayari yan parati sa condition space. The moisture pickup is SH4 minus SH3. Oh, that is equal to, ano lang yan, solve mo na. Napakaliit na value niyan. The answer is 0.12345 1 kilogram vapor per kilogram air. That is the moisture pickup. How about QL? QL is MS ni steam, HS steam. Pwede rin namang M ni air, SH4 minus SH3 multiplied to 2507, 2507, 2502. Pwede na to, yung mass ni steam. Anong mass ni steam dyan? Ayun o. 0.005106 kilogram vapor per kilogram tuloy, per second multiplied to 2502 kilogram, kilojoule per kilogram vapor. Cancel, cancel. Kilowatt din ang lalabas dyan. 2502 times 0.005106. The answer is 12.7752 kilowatts. US. Energy balance naman tayo. By energy balance, drawing ulit natin si hangin. Diba? Sa subject lang na to na idodrawing si hangin. Meron kang 0.3, this is 0.4. Tapos meron ang mass ni air at 4, at 4 tuloy, 3 muna. Tapos H ni, huwag nang H, dry bulb, 3. Tapos mass ni air at 4, dry bulb 4. Tapos, siyempre, mag-aabsorb yan ang heat load in QS. Okay, energy in equal to energy out. Ang kalalabasan yan parati, mga kaibigan, is QS. That is equal to mass ni air, CP ni air, DB4 minus DB3. Ito na yun. Kinortcut ko na. So, yung QS mo is equal to 83.7054 kilogram in every second. Tapos, DB4. Ilan ba ang temperatura kay 4? That is 1.0062 kilojoule per kilogram degree Kelvin. Tapos, 22, comfort cooling, minus 17 degree Kelvin na yan. Cancel yung units na same. Okay? Ang lalabas is kilowatt kasi kilojoule per second. US is now equal to, tingnan natin, 83.7054 times 1.0062 times 22 minus 17, that is 5. The answer is 421. 421.1219 kilowatts. That is QS. Now, ang hinahanap natin is QT dun sa condition space. QS plus QL. The answer is 421, mukhang 9. 421.1219 kilowatts plus 12.7752. Plus 12.7752. The answer is 433. 433.8971 kilowatts of total heat load. Iba si QA kay QT. Okay? That is for the entire discussion nung first method of all outside air supplied to the room. Okay? So, for more questions, meron akong sample problem dito. And I will give it to you later for further practice. Okay? Any questions? I think wala naman siguro. And that will suffice for today. Okay? Have a nice day. Bye-bye. Prepare for your quiz, ah. Prepare for your quiz. Okay, I will leave you with a practice problem. The notes will come out after the video.